The dissident party and its dissident father are both destined not only for rejection, but for utter destruction as well.
Ubaba nguye waqalisa ukubulawa ngesikhathi seGugurawonde, waba nguye waqala first person ukuthi kubonakale ukuthi abantu laba babulala. Baqala ngaye. Lo mama la ukuthi asurvive, wasurvive kwakusuka ukuthi wayelishona. Ngawo wayengasoshona, andithembe ukuthi lami impilo yami ngangikhona.
Babiza umkami sihlezi lapha. Bambulalela eceleni kwehadi. Omunye wayekhuluma laye, omunye ekhombele eceleni kwekhanda lakhe. Kwaphuma ukuthi khu, sambone siwa, thina bazanga besishaya.
Athi wena ngena, lawe ngena, lawe ngena. Wangena abantu abangu-5, igodi labe seligcwele. Baqamba lo baba kwathiwa lawe ngena. Laye wangena kwathiwa wena lala unqumise so. Babatshaya nje bonke thatha.
When if you liquidate Zapo, if the word liquidation means bringing to an end something, then it means you have no problem of dissidence.
Palitete wo, palitete le amtwazi, palitete, tete la wongulizwe. Kodwa lizobuya, hawu yeyeni bo, lizobuya, noma kanjani vele lizobuya.
Ibizo lami nguSinothando Munyo. Mina ngafelwa ngubaba ngincane kakhulu ngingethu yezi. Ubaba nguye waqalisa ukubulawa ngesikhathi seGugurawonde, waba nguye waqala first person ukuthi kubonakale ukuthi abantu laba babulala. Baqala ngaye. So ndisizi kakhulu, impilo yami ngikhule nzima kakhulu. Asafundanga. Babethi kubo mama bazabakhompaseta babafundisele abantwana. Asafundanga, asaphila nzima kakhulu, vele kakhulu. Lo mama la ukuthi asurvive, wasurvive kwakusuka ukuthi wayelishona. Ngawo wayengasoshona, andithembe ukuthi lami impilo yami ngangikhona. Ngoba vele babefuna ukubulala bonke labantwana. Amboni ukuthi umama ngawa engasoshona vele ngaba labantwana lathi ngasikho ngabe ngoba bayesithi wolela konke thatha konke uye thululele endlini kufi kuphele. Umama wasesizwa ukuthi wayelishona wayebatolikela ukuthi hayi namhlanje kunje namhlanje kunje. Wasesizwa ikogoni ukuthi wayelishona basebemdonsele umama wayezithwele isithwele isisu somnawo wami wayelandela. Babefuna ukuthi bamdabule vele bakhiphe umntana e-distance bamjikelele khatshana le. So hayi impilo yami yaba nzima kakhulu. Lo mna wami yena lo wasalezalwa kwaba nzima kakhulu kakhulu kakhulu. Hayi ngicabanga ukuthi hayi laba bantu ababulala ubaba hayi vele hayi. Ngangiyababona ngaba vele lami ngiyababulala. Kwakuthiwa ngukesarimo wahamba walwela impi. Wahamba wakulwela impi.
Okuqala singabo-10 kude ngabo-3 ngama-2-4 babe besithatha sonke. Basithwala basihambisa kwenye indawo kwakuthiwa kusedamu lapho babeyikhempe khona bona. Kodwa sisafikanga phakathi kwabantu. Bafika basihlalisa nje kwenye indawo khonapho. Kwakulabanye abantu labo khonapho babetshayiwe abanye sebefile. So abantu labana bathe befika ngokunjalo vele obamncane babe ngasakwanisa ukuhamba kambe uqalise ekuseni ukutshaya. Vele bengasahambi. Mina ngesikhathi beba khonapho sebengani sesile damu bakhipha nje babe lezi nqamu lezane zazinkulu. So bathi bathi uba mncane ngakuwa mina yabo omunye laye wabe ekhahlela mina yabo omunye wabe ekhuluma ishona futhi lakuqala ishona sasingakasazi nje akathetha ukuthi sesimixi labo sesidobhadobha kuqala vele thina abantwana bemakhaya ishona sasingasazi. So ukuthi lwana umunye kumbe wayesitekela umntwana kumbe wayesithina ngazi yabo angakhala khonapho babesuka khonapho kokulabanye nje engangabazi basukela ke labana babachavela obancane lo baba sebebachaya babengasabonguleli njalo khona babekwenza singale ngkhaya ngoba babachaya bebongulela sithese singale vele babengasabonguleli ukuthi vele abantu labana babesebechaye kakhulu. Khonapho kuwukuthi kwathiwa abanye khonapho ababesebetshayo kodwa bona besesengcono babethi gebhani godi babe kepi kodi labana abanye abangu-2 abanye abafana abangu-2 bathe besuka lapha ubamncane babe lapha kulabanye futhi abangu-2 lalaba futhi abangu-2 sebengu-3 kulalaba futhi abanye abangu-2 bathe beqeda lapha babethi labana sebegebile vele futhi babe agebhanga ukuyanga infective vele kumbe babengama lapha egodini lelana ngoba lami ngansasengumntwana vele ngingakahlukanisa ukuthi umuntu nxa elahla igodi kumele libe nganani kodwa kathesi nxa sokubuya kimi ngendlela yokuthi labana abantu babegebhe vele babekhanya konke lokhu bathe beqeda lapha uba mncane wathi ngicela amanzi abazange bethande ukumnika wona amanzi lawo bathe beqeda lapho babethatha labana abanye abafileyo labana abangu-2 babe bebaphushele babesithi kulabana kebekepha babethi libaphushele bekhuluma shona okuthi nje lathi sasibona nje ukuthi ngoba babese bebadonsa bebafaka egodini ongakuthi bathe khona bephushele egodini bathe beqeda lapho ubamncane babesakhangela ubamncane waphinda futhi wathi hayi into engicela amanzi vela abazange bethanda ukumnakekela umama elokhu ehleli khonapho kwekuseni umntwana akatshintshwanga napkeni kayenziwangani uba mncane baqala ngalo omunye bamphushele egodini ulo omunye wazwathi hawu kunani ukuthi lisidubule kulokuthi linjani lisifake siphila uyabo babemnyathela ngejambo la entanyeni enjalo selele phansi umama wabehlaba umkhosi babelanda umama bemshaya ngempango umama wajika soyiphethe umntwana mna ngathi sembona ukuthi umama asekhala kakhulu vele eyilayi vele sokuthi nxa umunyisa lobuhlungu lani lani mna ngabe umama engintiso ngabe ngithatha umntwana uyabo wathi sakhangela ukuthi kumbe lo bazamthiwa mncane kwaba into efana nayo futhi laye babemdonsele njalo ephila bathe beqeda lapha babesithi laba kade begebhi godi babethi omunye kame ngapha omunye eme ngapha lowana omunye umsotsha babekhuluma shona sabo omunye wabesuka esiyamuva kolwa omunye wabesuka esiyamuva kwalwana bathi pa kulwana lathi sayithuka futhi sokukhalana ukuthi khwaphana kwethukeni kwethu njengami nxa ngicaba ukuthi vele angicabangi kahle kahle ke lapho indaba lana yangamba kodwa kusalayo ngibona ngani lami ngawela phansi ngaleso sikhathi sokukhalana umbhubhu ukuthi kwayenzakalani ke khwaphana kodwa ngithe sengiphaphama kulapha ngathola labana futhi labo labana debegejisa igodi sebedutshulelwe bawela phezu kwabo bamncane obamncane belokhu benjalo benjani bephila bona ngoba bathi sebewelelwa engakubona ubamncane wathi so isandla lwana omunye nje odutshuliweyo wayesemnyelekile so legazi livuzela phezu kwakhe so ngabona isandla nje sisithi bathe besuka lapho babe besiyathatha abantu ngale lapha ababehlabelisa khona kwabe kubuya abanye ubaba abangu-3 bathe bebuya ubaba labana abangu-3 babethi kababagqibile benjalo belokhu benjani bephila
funa ukukhuluma engikwaziyo engikwaziyo i-ground yaqasa 1983 mangangifunda u-grade 7 la kwakungezimvu abantu bebulawa amasosha ayekhona ayebulala abantu aze asifinyelela lathi njengemuli sanyamalalelwa ngabazali abangu-2 ngisemnight abazali laba banyamalala okokuthi la namhlanje singeke sitsho ukuthi ithambo lakhona lila so-ke mina okwangikhathazayo okungikhathazela khathesi kumbe ngithi isifiso njengilaso ngithemba nginxani sithi isifiso sami asilo kucala nti so ngingathi isifiso sami ukuthi ngibone nje amathambo lathi sizibekela wethu amathambo kuphela ngiyakwazi ukuthi abantu babulawa bebulewe azange satshengiswa lethambo labo laphela abakhona esami isifiso ukuthi lathi sithatha wethu amathambo
kwakudingwa mina ngaswelekala ngibuye emahofisini ayazi yaphela lapho inkathi yakhona babuya futhi kimi sasidlale ibhora nje siphandle iclub yenkuba laphaya abazonithatha khona phayana ilanga lathi siyatshona laphaya babuya lami enkaya sebebuye lami enkaya la afika ngakhutshwa isicathulo ngakhupha iwatshi ngalobo busuku ngangihamba wangihamba sibili kwaphonga ufika nje umye uphazi lwafikayo ngakhululwa ngabanye amadoda ababengazi ukuthi hayi ngangekho kuleso sika sondoda owabulawayo enkuba semphumule lapho kwahamba insukanyanyana bazodlula esikolo enkuba laphaya the ngabe bafuna ukuchaba unkuba ngokwakho isihotiyane isifudlana lesiya imoto yabo yapantsha khonapho isipantshile imoto babuya kimi bezofuna i-wheel span lejeki hhayi ngabanikeza hamba ngayo lapho imoto yabo ipantshile khona kanti ntonzwa ukuthi yebona imfihlo now ngazothola ukuba sengilabo khonapho umye wangihawukile wangihawukile nje ukuthi uyabona mhlane kuyasi kuthatha laphana wawuselistini le ngawusentabeni katomi lapha lawo it was a counter book yile bizo yakho leni ye yimi lo mbani angumne wethu awe sufile lamhla wathatha irula wathi thwe wathi phezu kwebizo lomfowethu thwe wathi uzathatha leli bhuku leli wena wafa mna ngaziwa ukuthi ngafa
at the outbreak of the problems that we have in Matabeleland we initially reacted to the problem as a simple problem of law and order, and we sent the police units there. But because of the pattern of organization involving both the ex-Zebra dissidents, the political infrastructure, we got to a position where it was realized the police alone were being ineffective. We therefore decided to reinforce the police with units of the Zimbabwe National Army.
Fights between the Zimbabwe People's Revolutionary Army, ZIPRA, and the Zimbabwe African Liberation Army, ZANLA, date back to the 1970s when the two liberation movements clashed in Morogoro, Tanzania, and in Mozambique during the attempt to form the Zimbabwe People's Army, ZIPA.
There were a lot of arguments. There was no concentrated argument. The people argued on food, or people argued on training, or people argued everything. As long as it is done by a ZIPRA, ZANLARs will not be careful, will not agree with it. And what I discovered is that mainly, of course, people will say because I was a ZIPRA, but there was no instruction from the ZIPRA side to hate ZANLA because I was there. But the way the ZANLARs hated us, you could see with this thing, these people have got instruction. Plus, the setup in ZIPRA, as you know, ZIPRA was commanded by ZAPO, and ZAPO was a mixture of Shona and Ndebele people. There was no room to exercise tribalism. But there was room to exercise tribalism in ZANLA. Because you know, even if how hostile you are as people, there are some light moments one day or and so forth where you could talk. They could tell us point blank, good gentlemen, you are very stupid. When we go home, if we win, we will kill you. You people, you will die. But if you win, you people, suppose Zapo wins and Zapta is beaten. You will do nothing to us. Look at your leadership. Those are our brothers, fathers, and uncles. They will never kill us. Can you not see this? You see?
The camp commander there was Makasha, a guy called Ndakura Makasha. That guy was like, I don't know. But then, with us then, we were from Morogoro, so it was like, we were really raw. And we didn't sort of intimidate easy. I tried everything, but we couldn't team in that easy. One ball of contention came about when I was instructed to be a training officer and train a group of women and men, a group of about 200 people were to be trained. So on the training, Ambrose Mtiniri was the chief of training for the whole of ZIPA. And then during that course, maybe on or about towards 2 weeks training, the commissar, who was the commissar of the camp, started saying, yeah, you basikana imimi makupisira maningi. Mnotunga kudzimba muende. Say, why don't you go to the rooms? Makuda kurogwa manje. You see, murikupisira stereki. Because they were supposed to be instructed to go to houses, the chef, and went to Amgati. A punch-up got in when one of the guys said to us, Mnofanda kutita shona. Tukunzi tukwenda kuma operation, saka Mnofanda kutita shona. And we said, get away with that. I'm not going to follow that one up. So they tried to be funny, and a kitchen, we destroyed the kitchen, took the blocks as a kitchen, and hammered them too good until they left the kitchen. And then now we have to deploy at the Ipafule River, at the junction of Pafule, the Mbombo River. We have to deploy there to start off opening up there. So as we are going for deployment, that book guy, it's just a few days, maybe 4 to 5 days since we got armed. And that book guy again goes up on a stool and says, yeah, me magom rizes and I'm not being, I'm not thumbs a steric. You make me very angry. Because magapus a steric. Munorara steric. But then Zagasakara so because Mazibra Arguti Mausiku Magarara in him, whatora put then, when the Nazo Gumusha, when Ochera Davo, Zavaka Cherera Gumusha, where I will change right put. That's why I put then Zagasakara so he put the Sharu. You know? Gaza province has never been operated on. But how come you can tell them, Guti? Mazipra bani puti zavari kuno chere, wano no tera kumusha, wano tora zenyu nyuan, wano zi, mono puti nuna zavo sharu. Because muno rara stere. In other words, he makes them think that Isusu we are doing some night work. So, Munoto, the guy sleeps with his rifle held strongly.
Zimbabwe gained its independence in 1980, and the newly independent country had the onerous task of unifying the three fighting forces, ZIPRA, ZANLA, and the Rhodesian troops into one national army. From day one, ZANU feared that ZIPRA would not accept Mugabe's rule. Immediately after independence, there were cases of violence where ZANU youths attacked ZAPU supporters, and it was clear that ZANU was itching for a fight. By April, year-on-year statistics on crime showed that incidents of violence had doubled. From March to April 1980, over 2,800 people had been arrested for criminal cases such as theft, assault, and abduction. 80% of the offenders were ZANLA personnel, yet this did not stop ZANU politicians from blaming ZAPU. In 1980, Robert Mugabe went on an official visit to North Korea and signed an agreement to have a brigade loyal to him and the party trained. Mugabe called it the second victory of the revolution. On August 8, 1981, 106 Korean Army personnel arrived at the then Harare International Airport. They headed to Inyanga in the Eastern Highlands to train the 5th Brigade. On 28 August 1981, Robert Mugabe said the 5th Brigade would deal ruthlessly with dissidents and subversive elements. That statement left little doubt why the brigade was formed. Mugabe was already preparing for genocide only a year after independence. The ZANU win in 1980 stunned apartheid South Africa because they expected at worst a Joshua Nkomo Abel Mzorewa alliance. The South Africans wanted to prevent the African National Congress and its armed wing, Umkhonto weSizwe, from establishing a rear base from which to attack their country. They fomented instability in Zimbabwe by driving a wedge between ZAPU and ZANU. The policy to destabilize Zimbabwe by the South African Defense Forces was codenamed Operation Drama. Special forces working on this project came up with Project Banago, a top-secret organization whose objectives were elimination and intelligence gathering. In April 1980, Mugabe told P. van Vuren, the South African representative in Harare, that there would be no armed Umkhonto weSizwe cadres stationed in Zimbabwe. A very disturbed Mugabe was told by intelligence that there were 87 MK cadres at the Zezani assembly point, and for this he blamed Nkomo and Zipra. He said his relationship with ANC was distant and that he did not want the South Africans to think he was misleading them.
The idea of the arms cache, the big arms caches, came out as a result of the insinuation by CIO. In all the camps, even the Zandla camps, almost all the camps, when the guerrillas were told to surrender their weapons, there were small arms caches that were hidden by the guys within the areas where the camps were. So it was not only in the case of Zipra. And the CIO guys then took advantage of this. And they actually went to one of our camps without the Zipra commander's knowledge. And spoke to the commanders, for instance, of they knew the biggest arms storage was in the Kwai River mine, because most of the arms that came after our guys were in were stored, were sent for storage, including the ammunition at the Kwai River camp, assembly camp. And they went to the commander there, and they said, Osoneni Moyo. And told Sonen Uti, you know, you guys are stupid. The amount of arms that Zandla has hidden away, you know what the idea is. Once everything has been sorted out, these guys are going to go for you. They've already dismissed a number of you from the camps, from the battalions that have been formed.
They understand where Mugabe came from. There must have been a collusion with the South Africans, because anyone who tells me Mugabe didn't sell to the South Africans is all a complete lie. Mugabe sold because he spoke to the South Africans. I was in Zezani myself, and I write it in this book that when I was in Zezani, Dumiso gave me a call and said, "And can you please take out, if I'm not wrong," he gave a figure, it still is vivid to me today, gave me a figure, and he said, "Can you take out those 25 ANC cadres who are in that?" But what he was counting on is there were cadres who were in prison here, who had been arrested in the 65, 67, you know, the wars of 68. They had been locked up in Kano. When, after the election, they were released, those people. And when they were released, where could they have gone? Either CIO
or somebody, or South African intelligence, I don't know who, but somebody suggested you go to Zizani. And they came to Zizani, and I took them because I had ANC cadres. What did I, what should I have? I had to take them off the field because if anyone remained in the field, it was going to be shot. So I brought them into the camp. So here I have Dabengwa phoning me and telling me a number I didn't have. No, when I say I didn't have, I had bigger numbers than what he was telling me. And I can't argue with him over the phone. So I said, that's okay. I took the instruction that I was going to remove the ANC cadres.
The integration process seemed to go well until November 1980, when there were clashes between Zanla and Zipra at Ntumbane and Chitungwiza. In February 1981, clashes between Zanla and Zipra broke out again in Dabazinduna and spread to Ntumbane, Connemara, and many other camps across the country.
These things were still boiling up. Soldiers were getting angry and angrier as time went on. And especially when they talked even rallies and talked bad about ISAP and Zipra. You know, our arms were not allowed to hold any arms. So our arms were actually put into they were actually locked in a house. So even the commanders were not allowed to have our arms. That's how they did not respect us. Commanders were not even allowed to hold a pistol or anything. They were all taken into the armory. All the weapons were locked there. And as I've said, even the other soldiers from the other side, they started singing those songs, the Zanla and so on. What was disappointing is that when it came to radio and TV, it was only Zanla, as if Zipra were not existing. We could sing on our own. But that, even when we went home, maybe you were visiting your parents, they would only talk, why is it we're only seeing Zanla? And there's nothing from you guys. That means you didn't fight. Is that true? So you have to start explaining and so on. But that annoyed our forces. So what happened? They broke into the armor. That was in the evening. It was dark. So that they would not be detected. So when they broke out of the armor, they took the arms. They gave each other the Zipras. Connemara is just close to the road. So after that, they also went to the road and made a roadblock. It was difficult to command them, to tell them to stop and so on. It was really difficult because they were really angry.
Omahachi, they brought some weapons. Bafaka a church. That church was about 150 meters from the camp. Bafaka church. Then the Wagulavanto got dying. Soldiers. It did the corner supposed to be before Sunday. I want to be a church.
Yeah.
The Nurama is a mawad. Wamba could pray that this is broke. What? He must plan to my distance. What? So those guys, what La Panama, La Pau got to call. I go. I don't know what to say now. They did whatever they did. Most likely they took the weapons. I wonder if they also disappeared. They discombated them.
Yeah.
Also disappeared. So after 3 days, it was a penduka. Again. The penduka, la pana, inkambe, to wagu inche, so, wagu le dam, imu wagu camp. Then, pambi, we camp, wagu le, wagu heal inche. So I found one of the occupied sort of a C formation. Composedly camp. Those are well-trained bastards. So what can I say? They destroyed the armor first. My RPG is very boop. The armor was gone, man. So I found one of the nowhere to go. Armor is destroyed.
So they went to
them. They moved in. Made an assault. So these guys, they thought possibly he may have planned what could happen.
Yeah.
This operation.
So this was basically a fight between Zipra and Zanla guys.
Simple. And I mean, I was not aware of that. It's even worse than Ntumban. It's got more than Ntumban thing.
Oh, yeah, Kale Ntumban. umdala lo wafayo lo unkala nguye wahamba wakwenza irally e-White City laphana wagcwalisa abantu ababezithi ngabezanu bathe sebesuka laphana abantu labana sebejika amatshe behamba bejama ama-supporters kumbe kuthiwa ngayezaphi kumbe wathi wathi kwaze kwafika ezinkambeni khonale lapho esesikhona entumbane that's when abafana labana bezanu la sebeqalisa ukuzama ukuganga bethemba amakhiwa lana asegibe ixheqo ebhawu sabamukula-ke sabatshaya ayikhona mbijana bathe bephinde isibili isitimela safika ngabona past 3 sisima sisehlisa imbhobho chapa event wathi wathi thina sibagangele abezani la sebelungiselele esibilini thina sahle safonela igwayi layaletha ebusuku ama-grad b and so on bona babeqala njalo bethembe amakhiwa la edeploye egibe ixeqo ebhawa laphana lapho-ke bafa kakhulu amadoda lana okwasuka kwahlupha nje ukuthi amadoda ayedeploye umbhobho lo mkhulu owawusembhobho ama-secondary base betrigela khonale kuphela kade enye inkamba yethu yayikhonale i-Camp 4 kwagcina kusifa abanye bethu kakhulu.
Some ex-ZIPRA members deserted the National Army because they felt they were not being treated fairly and equally. It has to be noted that even on the Zandla side, there were several combatants who deserted the army for various reasons. In 1982, Africa Now magazine reported that 2,000 ex-ZIPRA and 550 ex-Zandla combatants had deserted the National Army.
ngibalekile esotsheni ngiqalisa ukudingwa ngisesotsheni ngiyekithi kulive ngaqala ukudingwa ukuthi ngaze ngibuya kithi ngasavunyelwa kunxa nisiza ngapho usiza emadebeleni wawuthi uya kuma-operation besiqala ukubizwa ama-disident siku-ami
into vele zahle zafanye uvati kwasusela kwontumbane khona pha um kwahle kwaba le-question mark noma nje kwakuthiwa emasotsha amaningi laphana ku-ami kodwa zathi amasosha amaningi ngapho uyatraina amanye amasosha inamba ufuna inamba enganani ngapho uyawafula ngalo utrainelo bani um singayibuza nje into esegcikeni otrainele amazipi ngoba ukhophe loluvele lukhona kudala la kudala indlela esasiphathwa ngayo endleleni lapha nxa kuthiwa uthetha ilivi kuzatshaya uze ukuthi ya utshaya umuntu ongatrainanga utraine kwalapha ekhaya ngasuke inkomo bharaki ngabuye intaba zinduna lapho okuthiwa i-120 ngasuke zabuya saqalisa kutsho i-training saya ngaphi tebhinga satraina tezivelale kwathiwa sesiya ngaphi sesiye gwanda ahlaahlaahlaayachiya ahlafa achiya vele mbona umuma wakhona akawumnandi vele ongamnandi ongawubonanga ewuzwa nguye ngathi wawumnandi kodwa wangena phakathi kwawo hayi ongamnandi noma singawubhula siwuthini wawuvele ungamnandi kwakubulawana kwahamba abantu abaningi wawuthi nxa ubuya ebhasini ento iyabile ibhasi elivele yaralulelo kuza ngophiwa kwana uyile ibhasi
yakuthiwa isakhamuzi la libambe ibhasi kumbe litisha lapha pholisa la isotsha yonke idefendente kaaabele yenze nje ongavele utshinge ukuthi ithini ususele khona apho uphinde ubonakale futhi um so kumele uhlale ubutshila kuphele elizweni into owalikhululayo wena kufana nokuthi akulalize likhululiwe khulu ilizwe apha futhi ukuzothwala nzima.
Academic professor Timothy Skanechia says in the early 80s the killing of ex-ZIPRA by ex-Zandla was a fact of life. They made life hell for ZIPRA combatants in the National Army, leading to hundreds deserting. We can assume that these were the nascent beginnings of Kukurahundi in the army.
Just on 1981, May, as a Barracks, as admin course, Sakreta, Sasuka, as a deploy, and a deploy a bread barracks, as a bread barracks. Under engineering. I don't know if I captain. Boxes like my cue by then, my your commander. Captain Howard, and seven Zalai. Such a Waverly came by signals a Queen's Park. So, Sasamba Seconale. Ah, yilaso wasilukuthi kwakutheni. Sabizwa futhi kukhanya sasiqoshwe thina singamazipra sodwa. Sakhijima ofisini kodwa wahamba lihlala liwe egathroom le. Lihlala ekhitini ngaleli. Ah, sahlala khona ngale. Wahlala. Ah, yilanga wasukuthi hayi, sesiyarari. Thatha sayathi it was January 82. Hamba ngayarari khona ngale. Into efika mina ngalandwa ngabe 1 year defense. Eyisikhwikhwi Redcliffe lapha. Kodwa yona siyasebenzela khona ngale. Bangithatha bahamba lami. I was the first woman ukwakhona enkambeni yakhona le. Ngihlala 2 days kwazophuma inkazana esitshoneni. Weyingumzandla. Sahlala-ke khona boza. Unfortunately ngase ngizithwelele. Ngakuma-tenant leave ngo-end of April. Ngabeletha ngo-May. Ngale 3 months leave. Ngithe ngibuyela-ke ngafica hayi sekula makazana sasisingu-6. Then amazipra were only 2. Amazandla beyi-4 ama-girls. Khonapho sisenkambeni naleyo ama imbubho yayisetshenziswa imbubho yewila ama-zipra. So yamount ake imbubho leyana kwathe kuthiwa bona-ke abayi kugadi abangeni emagojini la. So abafana labana bahle bahlakani bawurhwatshe ezinye isimbi khona phana amaunteni imbubho leya ukuthi abantu laba vele basuze bakhona ukuyisebenza ngoba kabayazi. Bahlala kunjalo ke.
So kwakho
namanye amazipra ababe khona. Yibo phela babe mountain ababevele babe lama ZQ lawo. Yibo babe mountain ama ZQ lawana. So wahlala kunjalo kungani kuyaphilwa kodwa kungakhayi ukuthi kuphilwa njani. Command wayengowezani then twice iwe ngumzipra. I think command wayeyi-1 wezipra upage. Kuthe sempendwa kumaternity khonapho I think it was August. Ngahlala, ngafika ngahlala enkambeni. So one weekend ngabuya ngapha koBulawayo, ngithe ngifika ngivela ngapha. Ngifica umngane wami uthe lapha kunzima ndoda. Kuyafiwa la, mina ngithi indaba. Uthi kulele kutshaya abantu labo, kulama-offices ayi-2 abezipra abulwe ebusuku. Kwenze njani ukuthi avele lami angikwazi. Sathi sike sabizwa khonapha wasatshaya mbishani sifaka kwamampama.
So tshawa umbama lisotsha.
Ehe, lawo lisotsha. But ngenxa yokuthi nje senior member kuyo akula nto ongayenza. Ah, ngathi lapha kusahlaleki la kunqona udinga indlu ngaphandle. Ngabe ngidinga indlu ngaphandle ukuthi akuseRutendo. Ngikuyilo kusho ukuthi akuseRutendo, ngoseRedcliffe. Ngathi uthi angayikhona ngale. Amkazana azahlalahlala, hayi kwangani i-situation iba tense lapha ekhempu lapha. Kwase kudosha abantu nje ukuthi umuntu utshayiwe, umuntu kasabonakali. So kwakulomunye ubaba wakho Sibanda evelele upani. Sasihlala duzane khona le Rutendo la. USibanda uyakuya ngililanga ntambama ngithi ngitshayisile. Ngibuya ngithi kanti Sibanda wabuvuka ngakakwenze njani. Uthi ngitshayiwe. Utshayiwe utheni? Sibokuthatha nje satsha. Kanti manje uthi lapha ngiphunyukile la. Unkosikazi wakuzithwela lapha useju. Uthi lapha manje angilamali. Njengoba kuphakathi kwenyanga. Ngicela umboleke i-$20. Ngihambe ithatha umama lo ngimhambise ngapha ekhaya. Kwezele ukuthi nxa yebelitha belithe ekhaya. In case bazangidoba. Kungaba nzima ukuthi bangidobe ngimshiye khona. Wena zathi ikhabothi lapha endlini lapha uzasaluthatha ikhabothi leya $30 ngimnike uSibanda lo. Hayi ngivuke ekuseni ithi umkazana wami ogcina umntwana wena uhambe uyobona umfazi kaSibanda ngale uthe bale ikhabothi abayithengisayo. Hayi ngitshaya mina ngimsebenzi nxa siyaphenda ngatamba umkazana uthi ngifice ukuthi uSibanda kabakho baphumile bathi itranka kuphelela ama-inform yabo. Lami ngihlale ngasayo khona ngalo nje ni-story ngiyazazi. Ngihlale 3 days kwami usuku-awulo. Silovile sebesiyakudinga. Befike endlini ngalo bethi watshiya into zakhe lapha e-inform. Akile ibuze ngaphana unkazana laphana ngoma afikayo izobathini. Nxa ngisahlezi ehhovisini ngizosembizwa. Kuthiwa ungabo Sibanda. Mina ngithi uSibanda uphi? Kuthi uSibanda ohlala la ngale. Mina ngithi uSibanda ngikwazi mina ukuthi ungaphi. Ngithi unkazana wethu uyathengisa ikhabothi ngathi unkazana afike ngasiko. So lama sasa ngifike khona njengoba izokuthiwa kakho. Bathi uyamazi lapho khona. Ngizamveza. Ngimazi phela ukuthi uSibanda bathi uyahlanya wena. Bangishaya. Imagine kwa lapho umntwana is only 6 months, I think, 5 to 6 months. Shaya umuntu oyindoda uyakukhahlela, uyakwenzani, igazi liyavuza. Suka lapho kuthi uhambe ekliniki. Umedic wayeseklinik wathi na
ayi.
Nyamazi, kuthiwa nguClaudius Chitakwa. Angazi ngiyabona sibafana ngazi ukuthi wayezihlanje ezitrithini ziyarari ngayo. Ngoba is the same guy wabulala ama-officers lawana. Nguwe vele e-initiate into zonke zokutshaya abantu lezi. And kwakungela muntu oyikhempu lapho wayengamkhuza. Even amakhempu commanders ingakhonzi ukumkhuza.
In my case now, I was arrested on March 8, 1983. What happened was the GSO2 Zetembi territories now led Major Chikananda or Makawi. He came with one officer who was a military intelligence at Harare District, which is KG6, which is in KG6, but administers some Harare-based units. That captain was Kutesera. I don't know what is his rank now. I was called by a sergeant major, Majemba. That guy was ex-SAS. He just came to me and said, the G2 wants you outside. I went to them. On arrival, the G2 would tell the intelligence captain that India Maliko Ajo, meaning this is Maliko. So the captain came to me and said, you are wanted by the Director of Military Intelligence. I really asked him for what, said no, he didn't know. He then drove from the unit where I was working, we passed through Camp Hospital. We collected one corporal, Francis, unfortunately, the guy is late. We drove straight to Caprit Barracks. So at Caprit Barracks, that is where the intelligence captain then told me that he has some instructions from the Director of Military Intelligence to place me under arrest. I asked him why, he then said no, he didn't know. He's also waiting for further instructions from the Director of Military Intelligence. He left Caprit Barracks. As he left, there were some junior soldiers there who point blank asked me, I was a captain by then, with Captain Intendant of Garenke Urumend. I was removed ranks. As I was to be put inside cells, that officer was back again, saying he has been instructed to take me to Brigade. I was put into the car room. It was almost towards lunch. They took this corporal Sizeba first. We were then separated. Then it just was. It was towards 1400 hours, still on 31st of March. One intelligence officer came, I later knew to be a Lieutenant Ruat Marufu. I called him a peace boss. I've never seen a cruel human being to other human beings like that person. I later learned from some of the intelligence officers that I befriended during our course of operation in the army that team. The guy really worked at Caprit Barracks, but he was a torture for hire to these other units, where you will torture and kill Zipra members, or torture until they soil themselves. Then you will be very happy.
In December 1981, ZANU had a three-day central committee meeting where they reviewed their plans and policies for the new year. One party state was on the agenda. Briefing the press, Mugabe said, if we ban any party, it is not because we want to reinforce the position of ZANU, but because we have considered that party to be subversive. The Central Committee had also directed that they should intensify negotiations with ZAPU to unify the two parties. Years later, ZAPU had to choose between unconditional surrender or total political annihilation. Addressing a rally on January 17, 1982, Mugabe said no other party could assume power in Zimbabwe. ZANU would rule Zimbabwe forever, and the government wanted to rout all political and economic saboteurs. ZANU-PF, Mugabe said, would resist this using all the power at his disposal and smash those who wanted to destroy his government. Ndinopika nambuya nehanda, he vowed. This was well before any incidents of dissidents, discoveries of arms caches, and all other related events. The stage was already set for the genocide, and the language of war was crystal clear.
We have people beating up people. Why must people beat each other? Why must people beat the next person? Why must you teach people to hate? This is no time to teach people to hate each other. This is the time to teach people to respect each other, to accept each other, not to hate, not to roar, not to kill.
Como should be the last man to say that. He is, for now, the only person with an active anti-government force operating in the country, which is armed and eliminating people, harassing them in both Matabele lands, north and south, and is being armed by South Africa. He's the only one with that kind of an illegal force operating within Zimbabwe today.
Continuing with the hate language and making clear his intentions to destroy ZAPU and the Ndebele, Mugabe said Zimbabwe was one, and ZANU saw no reason parties that were bent on destroying the country for their own gain should continue to exist. On 6 February 1982, the then Minister of State Security, Emmerson Mnangagwa, convened a press conference in Bulawayo, telling journalists that the government had discovered around 60 arms caches in Matabele land, half of them at Gwai River Mine Camp, the main base of ZAPU's military wing, ZIPRA, and another 30 at a farm owned by a company connected to ZAPU. Mnangagwa said he found it hard to believe that the ZAPU and ZIPRA leadership would be ignorant of the existence of the quality and quantity of the armory found. A week later, President Kenan Banana declared 11 ZIPRA-connected companies unlawful organizations. Mugabe soon after announced that he had fired Joshua Nkomo, Josiah Chinamanu, and the other ZAPU members from his cabinet. The arrests of ZIPRA commanders Lookout Masuku, Dumiso Dabengwa, and others followed the dismissal of Joshua Nkomo. The well-calculated discovery of the arms caches was so timed when most of the ZIPRA combatants had either been integrated into the National Army or demobilized. Nkomo had no military backing at the time, and for Mugabe, it was an excellent opportunity for him to strike.
We are going all out now to crush them, and we'll crush them.
1983, 6 February, la. Wangina bonaba behamba bebulala abantu. Mina banilanda ekhaya ngilomkami, ngayibasa umlilo phandle ekuseni ngama-6. Yikho bathe befikile lapha bafika. Babiza umkami sihlezi lapha. Bambulalela eceleni kwehadi. Omunye wayekhuluma laye, omunye ekhombele eceleni kwekhanda lakhe. Kwaphuma ukuthi khu sambone siwa thina bazanga besishaya. Hayi. Bathe besuka lapho bengu-2 babaleka lobana sisale siwa umkami. Sathi siyakhangela khonapho sathola ukuthi wamtshaya ikhanda lakwatuka ucezu lawela eceleni. Nangimbeletha umntana ka-82 omncane. Yikho ke sabaleka sama laphana mina ngaphenduka. Ngathi angisoze ngibaleke ngishiye umuntu lona ngoba izinja zizamenza zizasala zimudla lapha njengoba vele sewile. Angasala lokho nginjalo. Kuthe kutshaya izikhathi zama-4 ngoba kuthutsha abantu omakhelwana bakhona ngapha endamuleni phansi ngabo. bethwele mafosholo bafika bathi hayi kuthiwe sizonceda abantu laba abanjani abafileyo mina ngasezithi orayithi kwaye laba nawakhe khonapho yena umkami nayi hambani egebhela esibayini laphana esibayini kungani kumanzi bahamba bafika begebha labo labomakhelwana bami bagebha bagebha basebegebhile bangena bakhawula nje lapha ngaphansi kwamakhwapha bambiza bathi sowurayithi gogwathi sowurayithi bambeka babuya bazombamba ngengubo bamngenisa egodini mina ngihamba ngiphethe ucezi lolwanulani olekhanda sembuthile ubuchopho bulo angikwazi ukuthi uchopho umuntu buyiyelo kodwa ngabubutha ngafaka egebhezini hamba ngiphethe singabaqhubela egodini bafaka eceleni kwakhe lapha bathatha ke bagqibela engakubonayo ngabona ubunzima kakhulu isikhathi sekugrawundi lakathesi heyi vele ngizwa kuzima noma ngikulandisa so mina kimiwona kungiphathi kahle vele
sabizwa komaphosa kosobhuku kwathiwa ilayini yonke engayibuye khona ngale abantu bonke bahamba bayahlangana khonapho kwazothiwa kakuhlanganisa ukudla abantu bahlanganisa ukudla kwaba labaphekayo abaningi kwathiwa abahlabeli abantu baqalisa ukuhlabela kwabizwa kwathiwa kakubuya ama-youth abokungabafananyana khona kwama-creativen lokhu yikho kwabizwa kwahamba kwakhona ngale emasotsheni batshengiswa indawo ukuthi kabagebhi kuthi ngapha thina sasilokho sihlabela bagebha 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 nje igode elingakwani ukuthi umuntu efike so bathe sebegebhile kwathiwa abantu bonke ngababuye khona ngale sabe sisuka siyakhona ngale so bathe befika babekhethe bathi wena ngena lawe ngena lawe ngena wangena abantu abangu-5 igodi labe seligcwele baqamba lo baba kwathiwa lawe ngena so kuthe sekunjalo kwakulokunye okungumfana okwakumhlophe so kwakumfana lwanaokumhlophe bakwayengazathi kumbefuna ukuba yinkawu kumbenjani angikwazi kodwa babevele bembiza umkharati umfana wankhona nguyoko wahle wathatha umbhubhu wabatshaya nje bonke thathathathatha wazotshala lwana usenyaweni kuthe kuphela lapho baye besithi kakubuya abafana bezogqibela abafana bagqibela omama kwathiwa hlabelani vele azifuni umuntu okhalayo omama bahlabela 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 vele kuthe kuphela lapho kwathiwa kwathiwa ndo lalo ekhaya lakhe sabe siphuma sonke phuphuphu amantuye behamba besiyakhala besenguteni labo basuka bahamba khonapho impilo yaba buhlungu kakhulu leyana yaba buhlungu sibili ngoba umuzi wahle wachitheka umama laye njengomuntu wesifazana into yakhona yayenzakile yayibuhlungu kakhulu ukuthi ungayenelisa ukuthi uhlale umuntu wakho ebulawe ngaleyana ndlela yabe sungani leza sabo ngoba iinkomo zonke zazikhona ezingu-16 zahamba zalandela ilizwe kwaswelakala yena uyazidinga akula mntu ongalingeni iganga lakhona zahamba zanemoto so umama wagcina la esebaleka sesiya ngapha etsholotsho kugwayi ngapha elokuzeni okwakuyakhele khona umnawami omnye owayezempilo
ngo-1983 I know ukuthi kwakumhlaka 29 December. Ngangise Thekmayini ngaleso sikhathi ngingakabi khona lapha eDakamela. Ngangisanda kuba semtshadweni ukutshada sengumama. Ngilobaba ngasengihlale ngabona inyanga ezimbili bekwakuduze sanda kutshada. Kwakusekuseni nje ngikhumbula nje kwangama-9. Silokhu sizihlalele nje phambi kwendlu khonapho nje ngilabanye ndomakhelwana into eyenzakala lapho sezwa abantu sephonga ukuma amadlodlongwane bathi sebefikile sebefikile ithi siyakhangela sabona abengwane ezibomvu lapha sebethuthile sebegcwele indawo yonke abahle bathi namhlanje kunzima ngangihlala ngikubona ukutshaya kodwa-ke ngakubona ngalelani ilanga bafika babuza ukuthi kanti ibhasi liyanetshe laphana kwakutsho ibhasi khonapho duze kwakufilip laphana abakunanzelelayo laphana kwakule bhasi yayitshile khaphana ukuthiwa nguzenzeleni bathi abatshise laphana ngobani asathi asikwazi bathi hhayi asihambeni leyibona khona siyakhuluma kuhle khona ngale sahamba safika khona ngale sathola abantu sekugcwele indawo yonke kungasakhanyi Ah, sachaywa ngalelo langa. Kwathiwa ngobani abachisa ibhasi le. Sathi hhayi asikwazi, bathi ngizasitshela kuhle. Sachaywa ozozwa le ndlebe zingani ngazisezwa. Ah, ngamandla nje kaNkulunkulu kwaya ngezikhathi, hhayi. Sacina lathi sesihamba sibetshala babanye la sesenzinto ukuthi abanye sihambanini bazalibulala, hambanini bazalibulala. Kwazi ukuthi kwakumhlaka, kweqa ilanga elilodwa. Nge-second day yangkhona, ubaba wayesanda kutshayisa emsebenzini nje hawo. Nami ngimlungisela amanzi laphana ngoba kwakuqanda lelo langa ukuthi uzahlanganisa laqanda laphana gezi. Ah, kwase sebefikile. Babe sithi, hawu khulu, sicela usisi wakho lowo akasiphelekezeli. Wathi hhayi asusisi wami unkosikazi wami lowo. Wathi hhayi, wena mdala uthi ukuthi wena ungaba lo mntwana ongaka ungikhulu ongaka. Hhayi hhayi, kunanto enjalo. Asambe, asambe, sukuma sambe, sukuma sambe, sukuma. Ah, mina ngangikhangele uthenxela uza ukuthi hhayi engahambi unkosikazi. Ah, la wabe zithulela omnye washo wasukela kodwa kwamkhaba ngapha ngemuva akuwa ngelokhu zeni ngekhanda phansi. Ah, ngilami ngasukuma ngalandela abambukela khonapho. Fika laphana kwakula matende ababewenzile, babe baningi abantu labana. Ah, bathi namhlanje ukhulu uzamkhohlwa namhlanje. Hhawu la mdlungu wethu. Uyazi ngaqhuqa indlela ebuhlungu ngathi impengcweni yabantu basuma. Angeliswa kwenye itende, omunye lathi hayi hayi umbisi umfazi lo ngapha, umfazi lo ngowethu umbisi. Hawu kusuke lapho futhi ngale omunye suke engikhaba la engihamba ngijima sengena kulena itende. Abantu abangu-5 bonke abangibepha ngalelo langa. Kwaba buhlungu kakhulu, ubusuku obubodwa kwakungani ngumnyaka ukuthi kuphume ilanga. Wathi usithi ndilaphana sempunkuta megosi yami shiwa ngaze ngifele kuyona le ndawo. Bathi phuma hamba, hamba endlini yakho. Ngaphuma khonapho lokuhamba umzimba wami subuhlungu. Ndithe ndifika laphana endlini, indlu yami yale zindlu ezimbili kwakule khitshini. Ngena ekhitshini ngingena endlini yokulala. Fike ngisunduze ngapha ekhitshini besivalo sakhona sasingavali isiqini. Ngingityaqoqoda ngapha endlini ubaba ngifuna ubaba ukhile. Ahlathi buyela lapho ovela khona emadodeni akho. Abevula umnyango abe jika ingubo ekhitshini. Wayelodube ukhona nje layena lapha ababelele bendawonye. Uthi uyena lo wayelala ekhitshini. So wabe sithi mna wami buya sizolala endlini. Lo uzafika elala khona ngale khitshini. Ah, hamba ngafika ngalala ekhitshini khonapho wavuka ekuseni. Hhayi bangincengela. Uthiube wabiza omunye udoda wayekhona la kwakumakhelwana. Wabuya bangincengela ukuthi hhayi umluka hambanga ngokuthanda kwakhe. La ekhangela la udubekile. Ayisikho ukuthi bekuthanda kwakhe. Kwasukela khonapho impilo yami nomkamazange yabanhle. Ngathwala nzima kakhulu la esephonga uhlalela la ukuthi nizakuthini. Kwelilanga sesixabane ethi ha wena mfazi wekukura wundi wena. Hhayi, kwangikhathaza kakhulu, kwangixegisela umtshado wami. Ngaphila impilo enzima kakhulu kuze ukuthi la namhlanje loma nihlezi. Hhayi, kangikhululekanga ngempilo engayiphiliswa ekukura wundi.
Ukuhlalwa ngokuhlala ukuhlangana lokudlamulwa ngangiko gambu. Ngiwumntwana wesikolo ne-14 years. So igugurawondi yafika esikolo yasithatha singabantwana siyi-7 yangena lathi iganga. So bathe befika laphana labana abantu omunye wathatha omunye laphana omunye laphana omunye laphana. So wayevele sesihlala labo khonapha egangeni. Ngapha thina silaba egangeni, ngapha abazali bethu begejiswa izihlahla ngezandla endaweni okuthiwa kusejalume. Singasayi nekhaya, singasagezi, sesiphuma khonapho kuphela emantendeni kuphela, sikhutshiswa amaphenti, yenziswa into ovele ongayaziyo. So hayi, lokhwana kwasihlukumeza kakhulu ngoba le mzimba yethu ayizange ibuye iqonde kuze kube lanamuhla. Udlawudlawu lobana basihlukumeza kakhulu kakhulu ngoba besiqalisa sasingakwazi. Fika ugeja umlindi uthi angena la ngiyenzeni la ihlaluthi yenzithi. Saze sagcina sesingomama abakhona khonapho. So yibo ubudlawudlawu obuhlungu esahlangana lawo singazimiselanga singakafiki esimeni sokuthi lokho sikwenze. So yibuhlukumezo olukhulu engahlangana nabo ekukhuleni kwami. Kwayenzakala ngo-83 ekuseni sathi sivuka sise silungiselele ukuya esikolo. sathi sesiqokile kwabe kuthutsha amasotsha wagcala ahle agcwala indawo yonke athe segcwela indawo yonke babe besithi lonke phansi sabe sihlala phansi babe bevusa ubankhulu navela ngakondliwa ngubankhulu ubankhulu abevuka babe beqalisa ukumbuza ama-questions nangu grade 5 babe beqalisa ukumbuza eminye imibuzo vele abanye babekhuluma isishona abanye isindebele ubankhulu wayathi esaphendula babe sithi mdala usadlala wena babe yi-2 ubankhulu babe bebalalisa phansi babangenela babachaya nasikhala singabantwana besikolo sithe seqeda ukubachaya sebebathatha sebesebahlanganisa nabanye elayinini babe sithi thina sihambe esikolo sahamba sabuya sithe sesize esikolo sathi sisendleleni nga sezwa sokulo mpopho suduma ngapi esikolo sathi saphenduka futhi savaleka saya ekhaya sithe sifika ekhaya sathi kuthi abadala abakho lokho bebuthelele sithe sisuka lapho sabe sikuhamba nathi siyacatsha egangeni sasilokhu sibuya sizelunguza ukuthi abadala sebekhona yini sifice nya kwaya abadala saye sababonilanga selinga sebebuya sebebadisha kodwa ubankulu wayevele sedamejekile kwahlala insuku kumbe kwahlala inyanga kwaze kuthiwa sokusiba nomhlanga nokuthi sokukhethwa abakhulu okungakuyiukuthi amathisha avele anto ayesetshonile wonke sahamba safunda esodaka sabuya sokuthiwa sokulamatisha amatisha athe sekhona sokuthiwa ngama-weekend sokumele kuye emhlanganweni weyukuthi laba ngani bebakhulu mina ngangimncane vele but ngumzimba vele abadala kulami babebonakala ngoba ngincane mina beyangithathelwa umzimba kuthiwe sengimkhulu ahamba saya emhlanganweni e-Chakiwa sithe sifika khonapha e-Chakiwa bafika basihlabelisa nje basenzise okunye nje izikethi nje besitshela nje ukuthi kumele siphile njani siyiyuthi sithe sesitshayisa khonapho xa besihamba lomnye umsotsha umsotsha lana wabe ehambe wathatha umbhobho wakhe ehamba njengalala la enika ethwalise omunye njengalala la eduze vele i-distance yangikhona yisiba mfitshane mina wambika ekugcineni mina ngathwala ngabona ukuthi kathi waye mina sendithwala uma ngomuntu okwedlula wabanye ngabona lokho okuqhube ngabe ngisithi hayi mina sengidiniwe wathi uthi usudiniwe usadlala wena wabe sithi abanye bonke abahambi benji abanye wathi nzambona nje khona abanye bonke bahle bahamba ngasala sengiyi-1 wahle wathi kimlala phansi mina ngacaa nti ngathi ndilala phansi walalisa abankhulu ngale kuthi lam sendlaliswa phansi senginjani sengitshayo wathi ngilala phansi ngama vele ngase ngikhala khonapho ukuthi kwenzakalani lokuthi wangisa njani angikwazi ngambona sephezu kwami esendihlukula iphenti kathi namhla kwenzakalani vele ngase ngikuwa lapho wathi vele kuvele ukuwe wahle wanjengisa umbhobho wanjengisa ingqamo wabezenzela khona okokwenzayo vele ngani sesengumntwana vele ngingazi lutho vele lokuthi kuthiwa kwenziwa njani vele ngangakwazi ngoba ngangu-grade 5 kuthe sesuka lapho sesithi olright hamba ungafika ukhulume ngiza kubona vele ngahle ngahamba kathi abanye vele bahamba uma ngomlutshwane banjani bamelela phambili labo ecatshile ngajoyina nalabo ngahamba labanye into engifika ekhaya ngafika ngakhuluma vele ukuthi sebengenze so bahle bathi ngcono siye ngaphi esibhedlela ephumula ngahamba ephumula esibhedlela bathi befika esibhedlela ephumula baye befika bendihlula wayendishayile futhi engalweni la baye bendilalisa 3 days bendihlaba amajekiseni baye besithi hhayi uyehlulekile kasayenzanga lokho kodwa efuna ukwenza idoti ihle kanjani yachithekele emzimbeni wami so akasandamejanga kakhulu banika amaphilisi nje ukuthi nxa kule kunye kungenile kungikline ngaphakathi after that ngabuyela ekhaya ngalaliswa 3 days esibhedlela ngabuyela ekhaya sahlalahlala kwadlula kwaza kwalesikhathi sokuthi abantu abana sebehambile sebebuthiwe bonke bahamba sokumele siqalise isikolo futhi sifunde khonokuyana kwasekundihlukumeza ngoba abantu abanye abantwana besikolo anti basengasesaba ukuthi amasotha akasekho sesithi ah lo phela warejwa lo njani vele kwasekungistress ekilasini lanxa semfunda kwaya vele impilo yami yaqhubeka vele isinzima ukuthi nxa sengihamba bona babekuthatha njengokuthi yijoku kanti mina kwinto lokhuyana kuyanjani kuyangistressa kwaya ngaze ngafunda angisafundanga ukuya ngaphi vele ngoba ngagcina ku-form 1 ubankhulu vele anti wayeselezinyalo onguye wayengikhangele emfundisa ubankhulu washona kuthe seshonde lami ngaswela umuntu ongifundisayo ngahlala 3 years ngingasafundi umethi ngabe ngiqeda i-form 4 ngabe ngisiye emendweni ngithe ngifika emendweni ngahlala selomkami hhayi kwaba right kodwa laye wayekhona khona kunzwane ilanga linjani ngirejwa wayesithi nje ngilanga nje nxa siyabe sivuseni
ebe la kuthi kanjena na kwa harisha ukuthi dikho ngani kuya kuphambanisa angu ignore nje kuinto lokhana ngothathe edlula. So after that umngamo wathona ngo 2015 sahlala. So khathesi nje bakhona ababe senza kwa ama jokes ukuthi bethi ah lo yenziwa ukuthi wakanjani wakwa Rachel. So nqa ngasambe repha ukuthi kavume nqa uyala umnye umuntu so yini yakuthatha sekubeka ngezindlela
bathe bese ya reporter obaba kwasekuthiwa bahle babanjwa khonapho baqunywa imphimbo ngenqamo endaweni esesecha wakhiwe bangcwatshwa bebathathu. So bathe bengcwatshwa bebathathu one ndawo. So lapha bazobuya balandela kwathi kusekuseni ekuseni sibili inkomo zazingakaphumi kwasekuthiwa wonke umuntu emgodini kuthiwa wonke umuntu emgodini sonke sahamba. Umama wami waqalisa ukufika laphana wafika waqalisa ukutshaya wathi bemtshayele bamgwaza ngebhayinethi ngemuva la waqalisa ukuphuma igazi ngomlomo langamakhala. Kuthe kusatshaya u-3 umama wami omama bami kwathi wathiwa sukumani lonke asambenini bahamba bebagadile. Amasotsha amanye ayengapha emaceleni amanye engapha emaceleni abanye belandela emuva omama behamba besesente omgwaqo bazokhona la. Sithe thina kuthiwa sisale sasala sisemgodini lapha kulamanye amasotsha ayengangali. Umsotsha lwana wayengali wasesithi lani bantwana landelana sambeni. Thina sabuya kancane kancane sabona intuthu sithunqa la. Sithe sibona intuthu sithunqa lapho umama oyi-1 wahle wakhrosa lapho wathi sezumbhobhu sukhala. Salandela kancane kancane sithathi sizofika la kwakulabo dadewethu ababili ababetshiselwe kuleya indlu engangale. Then baphuma lapha bathe bephume laphana mina ngazothatha ukuthi hhayi osisi wakho sebephumile ngaphenduka sasesiya kuthiwa siyokodlamini siyegada amaphuma esihlobeni zethu. Bengaphenduka ngazobopha inqola inqola yakhona yayihlala ngaphansi komtsofilwano laphana ngakodlamini. Ngabopha inkabulezana but inkabulezana ngenxa yokuthi zazitshonene esibayeni the whole day zabe siyabhewuka ngale phambili. Kuthe siyabhewuka ngale phambili osisi labana bahle banjani inkabula zahle zangena ithwarha zabe zisiyaqamula amajogo khona ngale enyaba le phisi yabelaphi yikusila kwazo. Mina ngahamba salala emasimini sasesibathathu kwakulo siphetheni lo Thaba Dlamini who is now the late then kwaba yimi. Salala sembethe amaplastiki and kwakuyisikhathi sokuvuna inyawuthi yayiloku salala phakathi kwenyawuthi sembathe amaplastiki. Savuka ekuseni sazophenduka sizokhangela usisi sathola usisi wami omunye wayetshile wabhubha kodwa wabhubha ekhangele phezulu and into inzusa ubuhlungu ngoba ngabona ubunqunu bukadadewethu.
Babuya abantu labana kwakusekuseni nangani labantwana babili oka-78 loka 82 ole 7 months onguye ngangimphethe. Abantu aba bafike ekuseni thina sasihlezi sivela sengasahlala sithe lokhu sihlezi sabona sebefikile kwangamasotsha abe sithi phumelani ngaphandle kwegumu sabe siphuma basibuza vele anti umbuzo wangowama-distance sesebe sibuzile besibuza kade abanye bakholektha abanye usesala nkomo lapho abanye bakholektha abanye ngezindawo ngendawo emakhaya abo. Babuya labo khona lapho sesingaphandle the sebebuye labo sesingaphandle basibuza mayelani lama-distance sakhuluma esikukhulumayo uthe kuqeda lapho basingenisa endlini bavala sonke nini balayithe indlu leyana. Kwathi labana babengalabantwana baxukuxisa ivalo lesana basixuxa basixuxa izindlu zonke ekhaya lapha zasejisiwe but thina sikweyi-1 basixukuxa saqamuka ucingo lwana the soluqamukile ucingo lolwana baphuma phambili. Manje thina ngenxa yokuthi sasiphethe abantwana saphumela emuva mina ngaphumela emuva lo munye umama kwakuthiwa ngu-Juliet Moyo owayelo mntwana lesisu kwaba lo munye umama umisisi Sibanda owayephethe umzukulu laye saphumela emuva lo gogo ozala umama kambaba wayeqhula waphumela emuva the sesiphumele laphana kathi sebebona ukuthi labana baphume kuqala sebebalekile vele intuthu yanti yayibambile ekhaya. Bachaya umbhobho babakhutha abantu labana bazongena ekhaya Ngizwe ngene khaba bashuta bashuta uJuliet bamshuta wafa laphana lesisu lomntwana. Ugogo lwana umsisibanda yena umzukulu wakhe wawela laphana ugogo wahle wafela khona. Mina ngamaduze lendlu yayisitsha ngilogogo ozala umamazala. Sama eceleni kwamphethe umntana mina ikho engalimala khona. Babe beshuta ngombhobho ngimile nginjalo. Lama ngikwazi kuvukeni kwami ngazibona sengasela mntwana. Umntwana uthuthi wawa wahle watshela njengoba sasimiceni kwendlu yayisitsha. Ugogo laye wahle wafela khonapho. Mina lama ngikwazi anti umlimi uyakuphaphamisa ngithe mphaphama lami. Lokhu endlela ubaba lwana omama lwana odutshileyo kathi sebonile ukuthi umama akaphumanga lapha wamthola sefile. Wabuya kimi wathi gaqa ngamadolo ungene kulindlu enjani engatshiswanga. Ucatshe khona ngoba ungabantu lobana ungaphenduka ubuye kukuqedisele. Lami ngenza njalo ngangena laphana ngacatha ngalala ngikhoni napho ngavuka ngikhoni napho nomuntu nomanzi nowathi kusukela ekuseni. Akuthe emini yantambama mbeko kwakunje ngagaqa amadolo senzama ukucabanga u-anti womkami wayeseduze nje. Kanti vele bambulele ekuseni ngenqamu mina ngangakwazi. Ngafika ngithe lokhu engikhona pho sengomile vele ngisopha ngelanga lesithuba. Abantu labana kulabanye ababethutsha bezodinga abakudinga sebebalekile bangena iganga sebebuyela emakhaya ukuthi badinga okokudla. Babe bengibona, babe bengilanda. Bathi kade ukhona ngathi umntwana ke ngathi angikwazi ukuthi umntwana yena. Abantu labana babe bengithatha behamba lami egangeni. Sabe siyahlala khona le gangeni abona sahlala 2 months. Labana abanye babefile khona lapho base bedliwa izinja but ngemva kwama-days abantu labana babesilile baqoqana babagqibela abantu labana. Lami yikho ukusila kwami lami.
The government defended its actions, saying it had deployed the 5th Brigade to deal with dissidents, but it did not explain why women and children were being killed as well. For those in the system, they blamed every death on dissidents and not the army.
Khonapho ke madoda ikwelapho kwakulezi nkinga ke khonapho. Ngoba ekudingeni kwethu lava yazi kwakungekho clear ukuthi ezinye izinto zakhona ezazisenzakala ukuthi yibo laba kumbe hhayi because I can tell you ukuthi kona kwezinye kathi kwakusiba nzima ukuthi kona yona linto enje ibizothiwa because umuntu oyabe elisocha e-uniformed uyakwanisa ukuthi ayenza i-robbery sobona limthole limbambe but it turns out ukuthi no yimember ye-National Army akusiyibo lawo. Ngathi kuzaphuma kuthiwa yiwona. Then kwasekusithi ke kusenzakala ngaleyo ndlela sisebenza kanjalo. Ukuthi izikhathi sengizikhohlwa lezi nyanga nama leminyaka. But it was before 1985. Yayisi dlulile eMatnorth isibuya ePlumtree ngoba ngale yayenza ihavo kusasikudlela khona le mpela but bathe sebebuya lapha ePlumtree one brigade la kulesi le 1-2 la khona ePlumtree ebesini la wazikuthiwa khona kufuneka umuntu ofuna ukukhuluma isikhalanga so I think ngaleso sikhathi kwakuyimi engangikhona kwiyunithi le engangikhuluma isikhalane. Then kwase kuthiwa-ke ngibuye ngapha ePlumtree. Ngasenzi mina no, I can't go to Plumtree ngoba lapho engizalwa khona ngilabantu abaningi imbali. So ngendlela engibona kusetshenzwa ngayo ngoba if you uma ungathi mina siseplumtree khona ngale ngendlela engibona kusenziwa ngayo uza ubulala phela ubaba kumbe udadewethu kumbe umama so mina bese ngisenze njani because kwezinye izikhathi ngiyabe ngikwazi ukuthi kakho kukhonokho andiyabona njengoba ngaleso sikhathi abantu babebotshwa bephonga ukubotshwa bebulawa baye befakwa emajele and so forth. So ngisakhumbula ukuthi ngaleso sikhathi
abantu sebegcwele emajele esibili. Ngaba ngomunye owayefa because babe deploya one ZAC, one CID, one ZRP, one member yellows name. Twenty black boots love.
Support unit.
Support unit. All these security laws and organs. Also, only one. When you go to a way now, when a woman to mobile lie, who's still reason? You would feel unpopular. I'm too less enzyme. Job was a kaya should go ding his bamo. Pongucha gauge gang, go lap on a little because we have a child since the obvious we have shoot the icon up. Wow, lashes bums and one outside, but we have bungu combala or in
the
local sense when I was.
The question is, was Gukurahundi a genocide?
We need to see this in the context of a culture of violence, where a party in power has instrumentalized the use of violence against defenseless citizens. Of course, we talk about it as just incidents, attacks, but these are actually crimes. The crimes of Gukurahundi were international crimes. What has never been done? People talk about people being burnt in huts, women being raped, people being killed, people disappearing. But as a lawyer, I was always concerned about categorizing what was Gukurahundi in terms of international law. What was it? Were these crimes against humanity? Were these war crimes? Was this genocide? There's a lot of debate. You say it was genocide. No, it wasn't genocide. It's not that all Shonas came to kill Ndebeles. Do you even understand what genocide is? You don't need every Shona to go and kill every Ndebele for it to be genocide. Five people can commit a genocide. And five of them can be Ndebeles. They can commit a genocide against Ndebeles. So no. How was it genocide when Nkala was there? Do you even understand what genocide is? Before you start telling me that because Nkala was part of it, it was not genocide. You can kill your own people.
Gukurahundi, Shona for the first rains that wash away the chaff, was ostensibly for the political elimination of the Zimbabwe African People's Union, ZAPU. Yet it was, in reality, ethnic cleansing, ranking up there with the Rwanda genocide. It was state-sanctioned violence, whose ramifications continue to haunt the people of Matabeleland and Midlands to this very day. The victims need closure and answers, and both seem elusive as the perpetrators will not acknowledge the gruesome deaths of well over 20,000 people at the hands of a trained military brigade.